on you, how you bunch of weirdos? It's your number one fat Asian coming to you again with another China Road. It's all of the Fifa career mode. I hit my leg. Hi. And welcome to the penultimate episode of season. I was about to say dose, but that's four. Oh, you're on one today. Hold on, I need to take my brain pills. But first and foremost, I'd like to go ahead and say, for not only your continued support on this series, but over the weekend, because you, the Weirdo Army, has grown to over 50,000 strong. So yeah, it's just absolutely mind-blowing. I cannot say thank you enough. It's been a crazy past 6 months, and for all you OG weirdos, for all the new boys who have come along, thank you for joining me on this incredible ride, road to 100K. But I must say something. And it's with a heavy heart that I think I'm going to retire the moniker, the Weirdo Army. You know, I still will refer to you guys as weirdos, but from now on, you will no longer be known as the Weirdo Army. You will now be known as the Fat Asian Nation.
Bruh.
Yeah, you know you like it. And if you are a true member of the Fat Asian Nation, then you will go ahead and take your hard erect nipple right now and smush it with great ferocity right into that like button. And I'd like to give a personal shout out to one of you in the nation, and that, of course, is ASU Fan. ASU Fan, thank you so much for your plentiful donation that you gave me on the stream. And if anyone else wants a shout out in one of these videos, you can go ahead and donate on my next stream, because I am not above asking for money at this point in my life.
I'm broke, nigga, I'm broke!
And yeah, that'll be your Chinese word of the day. If you want to give a donation, you say, Bei Qing. But in the last episode, I asked you guys to go ahead and vote on what you would like to see for the rest of this season. And since we are warming up for the 2018 Russian World Cup, you said it was all cool, fun, and dandy. We playing all Chinamen for the rest of the season, pretty much. So that is what you are going to get. We're going 3 games, playing the Chinamen. But there is a caveat. In the Swindon Town game, when we do end up lifting that trophy, a comment said that, you know, you should give it to the players that deserve it. Rashford played a big role in the season, Locatelli and, you know, Traore. I should at least have them on the bench or have them somewhat into the squad. So I think I'm only going to go purely Chinamen for these two. For those who deserve to lift up the trophy, we'll have them in the Swindon Town squad. And I was thinking about doing a storyline in this episode, but I think it would just run a little bit too long because I also want to do an end of the year squad report once we are done with all three of these games. So I'll get the same for next year, or I might throw them into the World Cup episodes. I mean, it kind of fits. Those are the Chinamen-centric episodes anyway. So may the lucky cat bless you all, and let's get this. All right, Chinese Hogwarts at work. Ooh, no so good grades for you, Biggie Small. 3 games left. 3 games left. And I saw a comment, shoutouts, I can't remember your name right now, but he said that I'm not ruining all of football. And in fact, actually, I'm developing my youth and building through youth better than most English teams. And I was like, oh shit, yeah. So, you know, we should get back to our grassroots when we got that money. Let's do a little bit more, you know, destruction. Pretty much everyone except Tuan's Bay is a Chinaman in here. And almost all of them, I think it's only Tuan's Bay and Yan Zhang Yuning, who are all youth players through our academy.
Notorious!
Oh my god! It's him!
Notorious!
Oh, Hill! With the absolute flabus! Way to fucking announce yourself, Biggie Smalls! For some reason, no one barked up, and he said, don't mind if I do. Singes the crossbar. Filthy. Oh no! Wow, what a double save from Hoggow. Not so lovely. No! Tang is down! What happened? Oh, fuck you, Zoe. Had to be done. That was clean. No! It's gone from bad to worse. And it's laying meow. I thought it was a clean tackle.
Oh. Zoe, man, can't play defense on him.
Oh no. It's always going to be tough with three in the back. If we do give it up. Poor goal for me. Oh, Hugh! Oh. Alright, 1-1 at halftime. Sensational strike from young Biggie Smalls, the notorious one. Beyond that, it's been quite stilted. We conceded, and we also lost Wu-Tang Clan. Hit it! Oh, Hugh! Oh. Alright, not a terrible game, not a great game, though. Overall, it's a net loss because we do leave Mao. We got red carded, and then the big thing about this is we're gonna see how long Wu-Tang Clan is out. Lucky Hat, please, just like a 6-day thigh bruise or something.
No!
He's out for 4 weeks. No! Where are we in the month, though? So I think we're okay, because we have all of May to recover. We'll get him back by then, but just still, it's a little bit of a blip. Now, we do have a bit of an issue here. Not only is Rochdale the second, ranked team in the table, our Chinamen have shit stamina, so I'm pretty sure a lot of them are going to be pretty much dead going into this match. Actually, yeah. So I guess I'll just bring them off of the bench. All right, let's go. That's a great ball. Ooh. Oh, Dong! Oh, yeah. Oh. Woo! Oh, that's a great ball. Oh! Lucky goal. Lucky ducky goal here. Look at this. I mean, here we go. We kind of go to sleep, and then it literally rolls off a hog out, makes the stop, and rolls in. Oh, you sneaky, sneaky Chinaman. He literally nipped that off of Rashford, who's going in on goal. Took a little tuck into the inside. Has two men's beat. And then Dong somehow snips in between and slots to the near post. Shitty goal for shitty goal. And it's another Chinaman who gets in on the action. I like it. Oh, Dong! Ah! Tap it in! Oh, yeah. And we somehow pulled the hand. Plus, that's worth it. Let's go ahead and bring it in, everybody. Haven't done this time yet. Good low drone cross. And then it's the two fullbacks who are in the danger zone there. Kimson Beam gets deflected, but Holgate pounces on it. There we go. From deficit to back on top.
I get those goosebumps every day.
Look at this as he exterminates the ball. There is nothing left but ash and carbon. Jeez. All right. That be the game, bro. Chinaman gets on the board again. We get another win on the best team in, League One. And Renato Sanchez kicks the ball harder than I've ever seen a human being or video game ever kick a ball. GG. Oh my, it was left-footed from Renato Sanchez. You naughty lad. You are a bad man. There is no place for that in modern society. Here we go. Last match of the season. All right, in this lineup, it's a little bit of a hodgepodge. As you can see, we have Kevin up front alongside Pulisic, who's been fantastic this season. We got Cao Cao, another Chinaman. Renato Sanchez, arguably our best midfielder of the year. Locatelli showing up in good spaces. And, Tom Davies has been with us. One of our first signings, I wanted to get him in here. The guy who's going to be lifting up the trophy is none other than our captain, our fearless leader. Well, should be Cacao, but I think for this season anyway, Fuck You Zoe deserves it more than anyone else. Tuanzebe has been the center back partner of choice. We have the two Chinamen, these youngsters out on the fullbacks. And then, of course, the Shrimp Duffling, who's up to a 78. Very, very nice. On the bench, we got a couple of Chinamen, but our MVP of the season, I'm going to give it here first to Marcus Rashford. banged in crucial goal. Tenacious goals, just an absolute machine. And then you got Yaya Toure, who, for me, Renato's been good, but Yaya is the one that's really made it tickle, especially early on and in the season. This is the lineup that I'm using for our victory lap up against Swindon. It's been a fantastic second season here with the Chinamen, and I look forward to what we're about to do in the Championship. Premier League, you're not too far away. And then after that, Champions League, Barcelona, we're coming for you for the D. Wait, god damn it, they're not up yet. Eventually coming up to Barcelona for the D. Let's go, bitches. And a beautiful, picturesque day. Swindon, go ahead and set up with a five in the back. Ugh, this is gonna be a pain in my penis. Oh my gosh. Instantly, Renato Sanchez is injured. What the fuck, man? These past couple games, we're just getting injured all over the place. Ugh, that does not look good. Do it! Oh. Cacao! Oh! My god. Pulisic! Oh. Do it, Cacao! Ooh. Cacao's got a cannon on him, I must say. Halftime, we've had the better chances, man. We're making the correct runs. I think if we keep it up, we'll find a goal in the second half. Wow. God, how do we just let him take it down against the run of play? Are you kidding me? Guys, react!
Our leader,
General Cacao. Look at this fucking touch. Look at how he sets him up. Oh my god. No, he did not. He scuffed it. He totally mishicked that. And he somehow put it in. But that first touch, I mean, this is why I'm losing my shit. This is why I'm losing my shit right now. Look at this fucking touch from Cacao. Oh! No! No! He's like a 68 rated and he's doing Neymar flicks. Are you shitting me? The man, the myth, the god. Look at this beauty. Boop! Flicks up onto him. Puts it home. Bergkamp, Johan Cruyff, Ronaldinho ain't got nothing on our general. Get shit on. Oh, that's a beautiful ball. And what a miss. We're on legendary difficulty, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Game, man. We end on a draw, but it's fine. Time to lift up some silverware. Get in the weight room, boys, because we're going to be lifting a lot more after this. Get used to it. Another season, another trophy for China.
We are the champion, my friend. And we'll keep on fighting till the end. Boom, boom, boom. Fuck you, Zoho. Lifting the trophy of silverware is made in China. Sanchez and my other champ, yeah, my friend. Okay, I'm done. Yeah! China! Hey, yo, Renato! He isn't here! My boy! He's recovered miraculously!
Look at the lads living it up. We started from the bottom, and now we're two rings above. We're not quite there yet, but we're getting there. And since that is the final game of the season, instead of voting for your most valuable Asian of the episode, I want you to go ahead and vote for the most valuable Asian of the year. And choices are Kevin 11 for his fantastic showings. Fuck you, Zoe, an absolute stalwart in the back. Won every single tackle that I asked of him. And of course, there is the shrimp dumpling, Ha Gao. But this year, he has turned it on. He is our highest rated Chinaman, up to 78. And he's been stopping shots left, right, and a center. And lastly, but not leastly, kind of underrated Chong Lee in the midfield, our 6'4" CDM has quietly been having himself a season. He is our Chinese Conte. So those be your four choices. Go ahead, vote up in the I think he is. And wow, Renato Sanchez, even though he was bouncing around on that, you know, trophy platform, broken ankle, out for 3 months, which is fine. We'll get him back after the summer, and we don't have to face him in the World Cup. All right, let's continue to train up the lads. I think after this World Cup, the main thing that I need to get up with the Chinese team is passing, because I don't think we're going to outpace anyone in the World Cup. It has to be through our tactics, through tiki-taka. All right, we are now in May 1st of 2018. I want to quickly show you our monthly scout, well, our monthly youth squad reports. These are all the kids in Chinese Hogwarts right now. You see we have Yao Feng, center forward, and he's 80 to 94 potential, physically strong. And then we have Chao Chen, even better, 82 to 94 potential. We actually have a plethora of strikers. Big Wendu, probably going to be the partner for Fuck You Zhou. And then we have Dong Zheng Liao. Possibly our best recruit that we have seen in a while, 88 to 94 potential. Unfortunately, he's only 15 years of age and we can't get him into the squad yet. And as you can see, if we skip ahead 1 month, that gets us into June and our first matches in the FIFA World Cup. We have pulled a group of Austria, Spain, and the Ivory Coast. Oh my god, that is not an easy group at all. I'd be happy if we make it out of the group. I do not expect us to make it out of the group. I don't think this is the group of death, but it's close. Ivory Coast is very strong, and Austria has nothing to shake a stick at, and then Spain are, you know, former world champions. It's gonna be a baptism by fire, guys. But before we move on to the World Cup, let's go ahead and end off our season with Sanju Samai and take a look at everyone and the team and how they are growing. So I'm only gonna go over the really big people, and you guys can pause it at any time. There you go, Zhang Zi. He was actually our first keeper that we picked up, gone but up by +5. Then there's Haga, who's gone up by +8. As you can see already, Dark Green's been kicking and reflexes. Gu Chao was a free agent that we picked up. Mason Holgate, who we bought, up by 3. Yang Bei up by 4. Still needs to work on his physicals. Yo-Yo has been very, very solid, although we didn't give him enough playtime this year, up by +2. Tuan's Bei, probably our best center back, if I'm going to be honest, very, very pacey as well. Giuseppe Bruno got injured. That kind of put him on the back burner, but still grew by 2 this year. Fuck You Zhou grew by 6, and man, aggression, interceptions, sprint speed, everything is looking like the 16-year-old is going to be an absolute monster. And Phillips grew by 6, even though I don't think we even played him this year. Nice work. And then Lei Miao gone by up by +3, and his physicals looking a little bit better. Kim Soo Bean up by +1, Richardson up by +4. And look at this, that's what I'm saying, he is our Conte, man. 17 years of age, going up by +10, and look at those stats. He's speedy, he's got acceleration, he's got agility, and look at the technicals. Short passing is an 87, ball control is at 86. He's only 17. Gotta get his stamina up though. Definitely gotta get his stamina up. Christian Pulisic up to an 81. Wow, sprint speed at 90 already and finishing at 83. He is becoming everything that United States want and more. Kang Dong, very, very nice. Didn't play him enough this season. I think he's only made 25 appearances total, but when he has, he did put in, wow, he had 10 goals for the team this year. Very, very nice and is an exciting prospect. I kind of overlook him because of his physicals, but his technicals might be the best of any of the Chinamen. Renato Pereira didn't play, up by +6. Tom Davies got up by +3. Yeah, Torre down to a 79, but I did very much enjoy him. Scored 14 goals for us. Renato Sanchez, I think, came in at the halfway point, up to an 81. Only made 13 appearances. Locatelli has been solid, up to a 77. Liu Shang grew by +3 while he was away on loan. Kevin, 11. Gone up to a 69 for the Bants. And as you can see right here, growing in all the places that you need him to be grown in. Only 3 goals, 3 assists in 25 appearances. Not tremendous, but, you know, not all too bad either. Song, sneaky kid, gone up by +6, and he might have the highest acceleration of any Chinaman that we have. Li Kao, our fearless leader with the God touches, grown by +15 in ball control and 14 in dribbling. We saw the ball control. Yes, we did. He probably has like technical dribbler trait now. No specialities, just an animal. And then his younger brother, Li Kao, 64, going up by +2. Pedro Jesus went up by +2. David Neres went up by +3. a very good talent. Wu Tang gone up by plus one. We only recently brought him in. Zhang Yuning gone up by plus three. Still got to train up his finishing. He does, I think, yeah, exciting prospect, but didn't turn into, well, wow, a terrible season for him. 20 appearances, one goal, two assists. Yeah, I think it might be time to move on from the young man if he does not improve quite quickly. Marcus Rashford is tremendous. Gone up by plus three, and look at those sprint speed, 95, acceleration, 96, finishing, 83. Mbappe gone up by plus one, kind of been a little bit disappointing this year, I'm not going to lie. Connor Chaplin gone up by plus four, still growing. Let's see, Adjuiz gone down by plus two, Hohu up by plus two, and then we have Hiroto Nakagawa up by plus two. And that is it, guys, for season two of Sanju Samai. Stick around, we might have one, maybe two more episodes of the World Cup. We'll see if we make it out of the group stages, and then we move on to next season, where we bring in the likes of Isco Disco into Sanju Samai. If you haven't checked out my latest FIFA 17 experiment, where I, spoiler alert, have to eat dog food, please give my life beating and go ahead and click over here. Ding. If you want to get caught up on all the Sanju Samai career mode, go ahead and click over here. Ding the poos. Yeah, that's pretty much it for me, if you want. Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day. Remember to stay yourself, stay humble, and be weird. Joy game.